Hello, Clashers! Merry Clashmas, everyone! I am Game Lead Ano, and I am here to introduce you to the upcoming Clashmas update.
But wait! The log has arrived. Would you believe that?
Well, I would not have believed it, but I cannot refuse the evidence of my own eyes.
So the log is here to throw some leafy shade as we branch out into new territory in the Clash universe.
I bet you guys are pining to hear what we have to say.
Something sinister has taken root throughout the Clash universe, so make sure you log on to find out exactly what is going on. Hey, Clashers. All right, so for this Clashmas, well, Logmas season, something sinister has taken root in the Clash universe. The log has taken over Clashmas, otherwise now known as Logmas. And he has this really insane list of demands in this ransom letter. Unfortunately, my arms are way too short and I can't reach it. So, you know, is it really okay if I ditch the costume? You made me wear this thing.
I could also help you pull these closer, but...
My arms are getting shorter. Shorter.
Sure.
Okay.
Just get rid of it.
This way.
Just a moment, folks.
Ah, okay. That feels a whole lot better. In this Logmas content release, the Log is normally a Clash Royale character. So what relevance does it have to Clash of Clans? Well, we are introducing a brand new siege machine.
This siege machine is called the Log Launcher. And like in Royale, you throw the log spell, just one log. This is actually a siege machine that launches a log after log after log after log. It heads to the town hall, it does massive damage to the walls, and it will destroy everything in its way.
All while delivering its careful payload of clan castle troops.
Also in this update, we have a brand new spell, the invisibility spell.
So, this invisibility spell is a double-edged sword. It's a brand new mechanic we're introducing in Clash of Clans. So not only does it render your troops invisible, but it also renders the enemy's buildings invisible as well. So what happens when units are invisible?
Well, they become untargetable. So if the enemy buildings are invisible, your troops won't be able to target them and they will go for something else. And yeah, of course, that same applies to your troops. They will be safe from enemy defenses while they're in the invisibility spell.
Do you know what that means? My favorite. Mass pandemonium and chaos.
Also, quite a lot of probably crazy attacks that we've never seen before. We have a feeling that this will be quite the meta changer. What's more in this update?
Not only are we bringing a brand new siege machine and a brand new spell to this update, we are introducing two new super troops. The first one is, appropriately named, the Super Wizard. So the Super Wizard, kind of like, you know, his cooler fireball touting younger brother. This one, not only does he throw fires, but that fireball branches up to 10 times to multiple targets.
Yes. So previously, fireball hits, it splashes, does small amount of splash damage, things around it. This guy actually launches a beam of fire, then spreads out to all the nearby buildings. So it's going to be great for taking out closely knit clusters of buildings. Up to 10 targets, like Darian said.
Is that fire-tricity?
We don't ask, we don't tell.
The second super troop we're introducing in this Logma update is appropriately named... the Ice Hound.
Well, and obviously this is not an Ice Hound, this is Lava Hound, but just to kind of illustrate the point. The Ice Hound is based on the Lava Hound, though, and it is an infinitely cooler version of the Lava Hound.
So what makes it cooler? Well, the Ice Hound, when it attacks, it does have a slowing effect like the Ice Golem and the seasonal troop, the Ice Wizard. But when the Ice Hound is destroyed, it will drop a free spell. And instead of deploying Lava Pups, it will deploy Ice Pups. And also those Ice Pups will have a slowing effect on their targets as well. Yes, you heard that. The Ice Hound has zero chill.
This is not all that we're doing for super troops, though. We are also adding a new magic item called the Super Potion, which lets you boost any super troop available in the super troop building for free.
So instead of spending the Dark Elixir cost, you can now use a super potion to boost that super troop. And the super potion will be available whether it's through clan games, through the trader's cycle of items and possibly through some in-game offers, but it is a brand new magic item we are introducing to Clash of Clans.
And then, finally, the Super Troop system itself is getting a bunch of new changes. The first one is pretty exciting, since we are, from this point onwards, going to let you use two Super Troops at the same time.
So you can now boost two simultaneously.
Also, at the same time, you will be able to use the regular troop as well. So you can try crazy army combinations like Super Witch, Regular Witch, or Lava Hound, Ice Hound. The combinations are infinite.
So we expect to see some really awesome brand new attacks from these combinations. But the final change that we're adding to the Super Troop system is that we are reducing the duration of the boost from 7 days down to 3 days and standardizing the cost. So we've reduced the cost of the Super Troops across the board just to a standard 25,000 Dark Elixir for those 3 day boosts. To round out this update, we've got some in-game changes, some content updates, some game balances, some bug fixes, and some quality of life improvements. So, what are some of those ones we're introducing in this game?
Well, I think the ones worth highlighting are, like, on the content side, we have a bunch of new building levels, as we usually do. We have hero levels for the Royal Champion. So the Royal Champion is getting 5 levels more. Then also we're adding a level to the Expo. We have some trap levels. We have Giant Bomb, Air Bomb. And then we have, of course, levels for Siege Workshop and Spell Factory. Finally, one more thing worth highlighting is the cosmetics tab that we're adding to the shop. So we've gotten some feedback from you guys about the hero skins that are available for gems being a bit hidden. So we're addressing that and bringing them straight to the shop. You'll have everything nicely in the same place when this update goes live.
For the full details of this update, make sure you read the patch notes because it contains a bunch of other stuff that you're gonna find really cool. And also, make sure you click like and subscribe for this channel so we can create additional content for future releases.
So enjoy the update. Merry Clash...
Logmas.
And until next time,
Clash on.
Have you seen the lumberjack? Is he around here somewhere? I'm gonna stab him.
Pyro shock. Jesus. Come on, Darien. Get a grip. So bad.